cobia is an interesting fish because it really likes structure, and a lot of the old timers would say that they would find the wrecks before we have the sonar that we have now or the GPS. They would find the wrecks by finding the cobia on the surface. And what the cobia like to do is, particularly at a slack tide or when the tide's not running very hard, they like to float up on the surface. You can see them from a long way away, and it's a great way to tell where the rest of the fish are going to be. The cobia is a widespread fish. It's not just widespread throughout the Florida Keys, but widespread throughout the world. Went to Australia. It was the only fish that we caught that was the exact same species in Australia as it is here. So they're widespread in all different depths of water all throughout the entire world. And here in the Florida Keys, a lot of the offshore captains will target them on the back of rays. They'll get up in the tower and run down maybe 20 or 30 feet of water and look on the bottom to try to find these rays, and then they can find the cobias on their back. Sail fishermen are also running into cobias sometimes when they're kite fishing. You can see them offshore on structure like wrecks and other types of structure where the cobias will congregate around that. And you can maybe catch one fish and have maybe 20 or 30 different cobias follow that fish up towards the boat. Or if you're lucky enough to hook into a cobia deep, you could bring the whole school up to the boat. Recently we were filming Into the Blue, and that exact thing happened. We had a cobia, was one of the first fish that we caught, and with it came up four or five others. As we put up the drone to get footage of the guys catching the fish, we see off in the distance a collection of 30, 40 of them on the surface. And it was a really cool situation because the water was purple, perfectly clear, and these cobias were showing up in a really interesting brown color that really looked a lot like a weed line. You could probably mistake them for a weed line if you didn't know, you know, what you were looking for or were expecting them. You just look out there and think it might be a big patch of weed from the deck. But if you get up on the tower, you can easily see that those are fish. And the cobias, they just started coming a little bit closer and a little bit closer. We were able to tease them in with a hookless plug. And then once we got them towards the boat, start throwing some pilchards and having them eat pilchards. In order to get some really good footage for the show, we chummed a couple of cobias towards the camera boat, and we had bait on the camera boat. So I was just taking netfuls of pilchards and chumming these cobia in, really basically just hand feeding them right at the boat with a GoPro in the water. And I mean, there were many times where we had a cobia eat just a few inches from the lens. They even would come up and, you know, just try to eat the GoPro, or at least be curious of it. A lot of times we'll split the crew and we'll put a couple of guys on the boat that has the fishermen on it, and then the camera boat will just kind of drift off. In this situation, we did that, and it was a good opportunity for me to try to get some really good underwater footage by hand feeding these cobia pilchards. And as we kept drifting off, these fish just continued to follow us because we were the food. And we decided that we were going to try to take one home for dinner. So it seemed like the easiest way would be just to free gaff one because they were coming so close to the GoPro. But once we got the gaff out, they didn't seem so interested in coming around as it usually goes. So I caught one on just a jig to take home for dinner. a lot of times when we're filming, we'll have one guy, Jake Perry, he'll be in the water, and he'll be, you know, filming while the guys are fishing. If he sees something down, you know, 20 or 30 feet, he might drop down and go for a closer look. He's an experienced free diver. He can go much deeper than that. But on this day, I think he saw some permit and went down for a closer look. And when he did, this school of cobia, for whatever reason, either something that the guys were doing in the fishing boat or they saw Perry and just came up on him, but a really large school of cobia just came up right underneath him. He said he could just see their big white mouths opening, he said it was one of the coolest things he had ever seen. And to hear that from Jake Perry, who's grown up in the Florida Keys spearfishing and diving all his life, that's a pretty strong statement. But he got covered up with cobia. There must have been, you know, probably 50 maybe that came up all around him. Later, we think we saw that exact same school on the surface and got some good drone footage of it.